Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss an often asked question. Why can't the Royal Enfields with higher CC figures attain speeds as high as the KTM Duke with lower CC? So personally, I was rating the bikes based on their CC. So I thought a bike with higher CC levels should have more speed and power. So I should go ahead and buy a bike with higher CC levels because that would help me. But what the hell is this CC?
CC is the acronym for cubic capacity. So a vehicle with two cylinders having 800 CC means that each cylinder within this vehicle will have 800 by divided by 2, that is 400 CC.
CC is basically the volume covered by the piston inside the cylinder in cubic centimeter. The more volume that a piston covers inside the cylinder, the more will be the air to fuel mixture that gets inside the cylinder, thus resulting in generation or production of energy, thereby more power. CC has nothing to do with the top speed of a motorcycle. The top speed of the motorcycle depends upon the power delivered by the engine as well as the weight of the motorcycle. So the KTM Duke is designed for speed, whereas the Royal Enfield is designed for the power, stability and confidence. For our understanding, engines can basically be categorized into three types. Square engine. In square engines, the piston length and the cylinder diameter are proportional. Oversquared engine. In oversquared engine, the piston length is smaller as compared to the diameter of the cylinder. In undersquare engine, the length of the piston is longer as compared to the diameter of the cylinder. So in an oversquared engine, the piston has to cover smaller distances to complete one stroke. That means that a piston can cover or do more number of cycles in a single minute or more number of strokes in a minute. So the power that will be delivered will be more. These engines are basically designed to operate at higher RPMs or higher speed. The KTM Duke falls under this category. The bore to stroke ratio of a KTM Duke is 72:49. All the racing bikes and cars work under this configuration. The downsides of using this configuration is high wear and tear, heat loss and higher temperatures. In case of an undersquared engine, the piston has to cover longer distance to complete one stroke, which means that less number of cycles in a minute. So this particular engine delivers its peak power at lower RPMs. A Royal Enfield Bullet falls under this category, where the bore to stroke length is 72:90. The ratio between the RPM of the engine and the wheel is higher in case of KTM as compared to Royal Enfield. So the KTM delivers higher power as compared to Royal Enfield in this case. Compression ratio is the ratio of the air to fuel mixture before compression and after compression. Higher compression ratio implies higher thermal efficiency and thereby higher amount of power output. In case of a KTM Duke, the compression ratio is 11:3:1. Whereas in case of a Bullet, it is 8:5:1. The curb weight of the KTM Duke is 136 kg, whereas the curb weight of a Royal Enfield is 186 kg. As you know, acceleration equals to force by mass. The KTM Duke is able to attain more speeds with sheer weight reduction. But what the downsides of this is a loss of stability in case of KTM. So I hope probably by this video, I was able to let you know why CC is not a very high contributing factor in case of top speeds and why a KTM Duke 200 is able to attain higher speeds than a Bullet 350. Guys, if you like my video, do subscribe to the channel, do like the video. I'll get back to you with more videos. Until then, bye. Too cool. It's 600 hits with another fucking acquisition.
I'm living life is unforgiving. All I can do is pray for redemption, repent and pay my due penance. But I'm a mutant menace, mad science is monster. I'm not stopping, I'm globe trotting, no obstruction. Your mind is like I'm hot.